Hey guys, it's Travis with BPNorthwest.com. Today, we're going to show you how to beat the Spitfire sag. If your Spitfire looks like mine, where the rear end is sitting low and the nose end is pointing way up, it means that your rear leaf springs are starting to wear out. We're going to show you how to fix that today and get the rear end back up like it used to be when it rolled off the factory floor, and we're going to improve the handling by doing so. Well, to beat the Spitfire sag, we're going to put a new rear leaf spring in our car. Now, this leaf spring is a lot different than the one that came from the factory. First, it has 6 leaves in it instead of 5. The other thing is it's bound together a heck of a lot better than the original one. Here's one that I have from the factory that was on an old Spitfire. And the first thing you might not notice is it's sitting a little bit lower, and it's not because it was designed that way. It's just because it's 30, 40 years old, and the weight of the car has been wearing it down, and it's just been losing its arch. The other thing you're going to notice is it's not bound together as well as the new one is. So with the combination of that, it's going to really bring the rear end of your Spitfire up, and it's going to improve the handling. Here's some of the tools that we're going to need to put our new leaf spring in. We're going to need a hammer. We're going to need a set of channel locks. We're also going to need a flat bar or some flat piece of metal that we can tap our hammer against. You're going to need a socket wrench with a half, a 9/16, 5/8, and 11/16 sockets. You're going to want some anti-seize. You're going to need a flathead screwdriver, a couple of box-end wrenches, a 9/16, a half, a 5/16, and you're also going to need a punch. Now, preferably if you have a brass punch, those always work the best because they don't mar the metal because this is so soft. If you don't have one, it's no big deal. All right, now that we've got our tools and we've got our part ready to go, the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to chalk the front tires, we're going to jack up the back of the car and take both rear tires off, and then we want to drop it down on some jack stands or some wooden blocks, whatever you have. Now that you got the rear tires off and the car is blocked up, you want to grab a 5/8 and 11/16 socket. If you have 2 sockets, that works best, or if you have a cheater bar, that's what I always use. You're going to want to start taking this bolt out of the leaf spring back here. Okay. Now that you have your nut off, you're actually going to want to put it back on a little bit. Just a couple of turns, not very far, just enough so it catches really good. Then you're going to want to grab your flat bar or your piece of metal that you're going to hammer against and put it up against that nut and tap it and start getting that bolt to push out. Now, if it's giving you a hard time and being stubborn on coming out, don't hammer on it because that's how you ruin threads. What you're going to want to do is grab your jack and put it up under this crossmember bar and start relieving a little bit of that tension on there, and that might help a little bit too. Now, once you've gotten your bolt as far as it's going to go ahead and take it out, and then take your punch, put it in the middle of that bolt, and again, don't hammer on this thing. But just tap it, just kind of coax that bolt out of there. Once you get it to a certain point, and it still won't come out, you can grab your channel locks, put it around this collar. You don't have to grab it very hard, just enough to catch the back of the head, and then you can tap on your channel locks. Get it to come out the rest of the way. The next thing we're going to want to do is take this rear panel out. Some of them are screwed in, some of them just sit in. Either way, if yours has screws, of course take them out and get this panel out of the way. Now you're going to notice there's an access panel back here. This gets us to the top of the leaf spring and the rear differential. Most cars have a couple of screws in it. Mine has a couple of bolts and they're 5/16. You're going to want to go ahead and take that off. Now that you got your bolts out, you might have to pop this loose. Be real careful. There's a gasket material back there that kind of helps seal this. Now you're going to notice that now that we have this panel off, there's four bolts back here. We're going to want to take these bolts off, but we're also going to want to take these studs out. These studs go all the way down into the top of the rear differential. So grab your half inch and start taking one of these off. Now I'm kind of getting lucky here because this is taking the stud with it. But if you start taking one of these off and it doesn't take the stud with it, take that nut, put it on the next stud, and use it as a jam nut. Start pulling the bottom nut off, it'll take that whole stud with it. Okay, as I was getting the bolts out, this last nut gave way. So it started turning with it. So what I had to do is I had to get another nut off of a different stud, and I'm putting it right down on top. Now, I'm gonna go against that bottom nut out. Now it's gonna force it to take that stud with it. So if your nuts are coming off of the stud, then this is how you get them out. Now that you got your bolts out of each side and you got four nuts and studs out of the top, all you have to do is slide it out. Now you might have to get a flat bar and pry it loose of these vertical strands here. Now as you're sliding it out, if it gets hung up and you can't wiggle it out, remember you can always take your lower jack off, and that will give you a little bit more give here to make some room to slide some stuff out. Now that your spring is out, the last thing to do is grab a half inch box end and socket. Take this bolt and nut right out of here that holds on this top piece. Now that that's off and the bolt is out, take this top piece off, because you're going to need that for the reinstallation of the next part. This is the spring that we just pulled out of that Spitfire. Put it in front of the new spring and you can really tell the difference. Now it's easy to see what causes the Spitfire sag. Now before we slide our new spring into place, you're going to want to take the bottom of both shocks off. So grab an 11/16 ratchet and start loosening it up. Now when it comes time to slide this off, you can pry against this vertical link, but if it becomes difficult, don't force it real hard. If it becomes too difficult, take your jack and start jacking up and take right here and take a little bit of the pressure off of that, and it should slide off a lot easier. I decided to take the top of this shock off to show you how much space you gain by dropping the shocks on both sides. Now that the shocks are loose, it's time to slide your spring into place. Now if you notice on the bottom, there's a little bit of a knob down here, and that's going to settle into a hole that's on the top of the differential. Now if the new knob doesn't quite fit into that hole, then you can take it out using an Allen head key, and then you can replace it with the one that was on your old one. Now that we got it in, let's go up top and slide that knob down into the hole. Now that you have your spring in and it's about centered, you're going to want to wiggle it around a little bit until that knob falls into that slot on top of the differential. It's going to make a bit of a clunk in your feel it. Now that it's centered, the next thing you want to do is take your bracket and drop it right in on top of it. Now you're going to be able to see from this vantage point where those studs are going to go in. So you're going to want to start taking your studs and put some anti-seize on them and start putting them in finger tight. Alright guys, we're in the home stretch. Go ahead and get your nuts on these studs, and I like to tighten them up in an X pattern. Get them down nice and snug. But don't put your access panel on when we're done here, because once we get the bolts and the ends and the tires back on, we're going to want to come back and tighten these again once there's weight on the rear end. All right, now it's time to get our spring hooked back through the vertical link. And what we're going to need to do here is we're going to need to get a pry bar up underneath here and start pushing it up. Now, one thing you may notice is that your vertical links are a little bit tighter together than they would need to be to accept this new spring. Now, if that's the case, just get your screwdriver down in there and pry it out just a little bit, nice and easy. Don't want to go anything bigger than we need to, so we just want to go a little bit at a time and check it out. Now, once it's in, again, we're going to have our pry bar in there, have our bolt ready, so when we start getting close, we can slide it right in there. Another important thing I want to tell you is if you're tired right now, take a break, because we're going to need to use a hammer to tap this bolt in. And if you're frustrated, sometimes you get a little aggressive with that hammer, Lord knows I do, and you start ruining threads and you start messing up vertical links. So let's start nice and easy and see what we come up with. Okay, now it's got in between, but my vertical link is tilted a little too far forward. So I'm gonna try and take my hammer and tap it back into place. Don't hammer on it, just tap. And if it's not moving, relieve the pressure on the spring and start all over again. Now, if you're lucky enough, like I just was, to have that bolt go all the way through, cool. But if it doesn't, if that bolt goes through and it looks like these vertical links are maybe a little bit misaligned, here's a good trick. Grab a pair of channel locks and catch the edge, open them all the way up, catch the inside lip of this vertical link, and then pull it around and grab the outside edge of this new spring on the link that's not accepting the bolt yet. Give it a little bit of pressure and you can get those things to just start lining up enough to push that bolt through. Now we just put on our flat washer, tighten up our nut, and then we're going to, once we get this up snug, we're gonna move to the other side, do the same thing, but then don't forget, we gotta do our shocks, and we're gonna do them after we get the spring in place. Now there's springs bolted on both sides. I'm gonna come back and jack this up off the stabilizer link here to get our shocks put back into place. Now that we got the tires bolted back on and the weight back down on the car, we've gone up top and snugged those bolts up one last time and put the access panel on. Now, we're done. After about 400 or 500 miles, you're only going to go back through and just tighten everything up once again, just to make sure it's all nice and snug. Out of all the upgrades that you can do to your British car, this is one of my favorites. It's very inexpensive and the results are dramatic. It really brings the back end of your car back up the way it was when it rolled off the factory floor and just gives it a much prouder look. You're going to be really happy you did this one. If you have any questions or any trouble along the way, as always, give us an email at howto@bpnorthwest.com. You can give us a call at 503-864-2001. Thanks again for watching. Enjoy the ride.